my channel. My name is Cambria and I'm a 17-year-old mom to my daughter Everly, and this is my boyfriend Dalton.
Hi.
He wanted to do this video with me. He actually said, "Can I do the video with you?" So I'm letting him. But today we're doing the controversial parenting tag, so I picked a few questions off of them and we're just gonna answer the questions. So basically I'm gonna read off the question, say my opinion about it, and then he's either going to agree or give his side of how he feels. So yeah, they're written on a piece of paper, so that's what I'm looking at if I'm looking down. And also, if you hear a rocking noise, Everly's in her rocking place. So yeah. So the first question is pro-life or pro-choice. I'm pro-choice when it comes to, like, if someone is raped or if you are told, like, you're going to die if you give birth, or your baby's not going to live very long after you give birth. So that's when I'm pro-choice. And then I'm pro-life when someone just wants to kill their baby just because they don't want to have a baby, because I think there's other alternatives, such as, like, adoption or giving, like, your mom or dad or grandma or grandpa custody of your kid. So, yeah.
I agree with that one.
The second one is circumcision. We don't agree on this topic. I personally, one reason I'm glad that Everly is a girl is because I don't know if I'd be able to decide, but I don't think that I would circumcise my son, just because I see it as a cosmetic thing and pain that your baby doesn't have to go through for it. Like, newborns go through enough when they're being born and, like, coming out of the womb and everything. So I would not circumcise my son just because it is cosmetic, and I don't think God would put it on your body if it wasn't supposed to be there. And if my son was older and said he wanted it done, then I would pay for it. But yeah, I don't think I would circumcise my son. I mean, just because, like, oh, this is weird to say, just because my personal preference is, like, non-circumcised. I mean, I've only slept with him. Sorry, mom and dad, if you're watching this, but I've only slept with him, and so my personal preference is non-circumcised. So I don't think it's right for, like, parents to put their preference on their son, if that makes sense. So just because I don't like it, why should I put my preference on my kid? So I would let him decide.
Wait, aren't I, it's considered circumcised.
What?
I'm considered circumcised.
Yeah, that's what I said.
You said non-circumcised.
Oh, okay, whatever.
I think kids should be circumcised.
Why? You have to back
because
it up.
I think that it's just a normal thing to do, and I'm just go with the normal. I don't like not going with the normal, so there you go.
I guess he sees it as a normal thing because most people nowadays are circumcised. I see it as a cosmetic thing and pain that your baby doesn't need to go through, so that's our sides to it, I guess. The next question is adoption. I think adoption is a really good thing, like, whether you're adopting a kid and, like, bringing them into your family, either because you couldn't conceive kids or you just want to. I think that's really great, like, giving a kid something that they could never have from their biological family. Also, that also means, like, if putting kids up for adoption is okay, and I think that's perfectly fine too, because I think that's better than killing a baby for, like, with abortion. I think adoption is good with that way too.
I agree with that one.
The next question is breast milk or formula. I'm not, like, super opinionated about this. I mean, breast is best. That's, like, the saying or whatever. Everly, while I was pregnant with Everly, my whole plan was to, like, exclusively breastfeed, like, not pump at all. And then when she was born, the 2 days that we were in the hospital, I tried to breastfeed her, and she had an issue with keeping her tongue down to, like, actually latch correctly. So I could no longer breastfeed, because when babies are in the hospital, they're not supposed to lose more than 10% of their body weight, and she had lost more than 10%. So then I started to pump, and my supply was really good for a while, and then it started decreasing. So, like, I upped how much water I drank, and that didn't help, and then I upped my calories, and that didn't help either. So I eventually ran out of my milk supply, so now she does have to drink formula, which I cried about when I had to switch her to formula, because, I don't know, I just felt bad. But I think that you should try breastfeeding or at least pumping if you can. That's just my opinion though. I mean, a fed baby is a good baby, but yeah.
I would do breast milk and then formula if you had to.
Yeah, I just think breast is the healthiest and it's better for their stomachs and everything. The next question is the cry it out method. I would never use the cry it out method on Everly. She's right now because she's only 3 months. So I don't think it's a good thing to use it on a baby, just because when a baby cries, that means they need something. So whether that's to be held, fed, or like changed, whatever. But I think like a 4 or 5 year old and like that age, if they're just crying because they don't want to go to bed or they're just throwing a tantrum, then I think that's fine because you know that that's what they're doing and they can tell you that and like talk and everything.
Yeah, that's what I feel too.
So we would never use it on Everly now, but when she's older, I feel like we would. Okay. The next question is spanking. I don't know. Would you spank Everly?
Not now.
Well, obviously we wouldn't spank her now, but I think like spanking's okay when your child is older, just because it really shows them that they shouldn't be doing that and like that's really bad. But I think it's wrong when people spank kids to just take their anger out. Like, that's abuse then. But I think spanking to teach them a lesson is fine.
Yeah.
But like, there has to be a certain age that we would start it. Like, we wouldn't do it when she's like a baby.
Would you stop it at a certain age too?
Well, yeah. The next question is home, public, private, or charter schooling. We'll probably put her in public school to start out, right?
Sure.
Yeah, we'd probably start her out in public school, and then if she had an issue with something, then we'd switch her to whatever works best for her. It's really just whatever works best for her. Like, I did online to finish high school because I got pregnant with her, and just what worked best for me. So I don't see a problem with any of them. I don't think I would ever homeschool her, just because if I wanted to be a teacher, I would have gone to school to be a teacher. So I don't think I'd ever homeschool her, but the other three, I think whatever works best for her.
Yeah. I went to private school, so.
Yeah, he went to private school up until high school. That's just how our town works. If you go to private school, you go up until your freshman year, and then you go to a public high school. And I went to public school my whole life, and I think we turned out fine.
Well, I don't know about you, but.
Okay, really. Then the next question is vaccinations. Everly is vaccinated just simply because she's a baby and babies' immune systems are weaker. I'm not vaccinated. Like, I don't get the flu shot or anything, and you don't either, right?
No, I don't remember the last time I got a shot.
Yeah. Well, yeah, so neither of us are vaccinated. She's vaccinated because she's a baby and just because of her immune system. I don't know if she'll be vaccinated her whole life, but for now she is. So, yeah.
I hated getting shots when I was a little.
Yeah. The next question is medicating children. So that means like ADHD medicine or like depression medicine. Personally, I would try something like alternative first, like maybe get my kid into a sport that they enjoyed, or like I don't know, like crafts or an instrument or something. And then if that didn't help, then I would try the medicine. But I definitely wouldn't just give my kid medicine right off the bat. That's just my personal opinion.
Yeah, I pretty much agree with her.
Just because I think if you can go without medicine, you might as well just do that. I mean, it's better for your body too. Since we have a little bit more time, should we do one more?
Sure.
Then the next question is baby wearing. I think this is kind of a stupid question, just because I don't see anything wrong with putting your baby in a baby carrier if you have to get stuff done or walking around. Or if you're walking around somewhere, like in my vlog yesterday, I had to put her in a baby carrier to clean because I had to get stuff done, and she's at the stage now where sometimes she just needs me and she'll cry until I can hold her, and some days I can't just sit and hold her. Like yesterday, I actually had to get stuff done. I don't see a problem with baby wearing.
We did it this summer when we went to a maze because it couldn't push a stroller through the maze.
Like there's certain places where you can't push a stroller, so I don't see the problem. And also we went hiking too, so obviously you can't push a stroller through that. Co-sleeping, we don't co-sleep just because our bed is literally big enough for the two of us. It's a full-size bed, so there's not enough room, and he's a pretty, like, rough sleeper. Like, once he's asleep, so he's scared that he would roll over onto her. I mean, I know there are things you can put in the bed so that that wouldn't happen, but it's just a personal preference. She sleeps in her rock and play just fine, and then once she grows out that, she'll sleep in her crib, and I don't see the point of co-sleeping just because she sleeps fine in her rock and play. If she needed it, we'd probably try it, but she's fine.
Yeah. I think.
Like, yeah, if she needed it, we'd do it, but for now, she doesn't need it. And also, I think then kids want to sleep with you until they're like six, which I don't want, you know?
Yeah.
I think that's going to be it for today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed, and hope you guys enjoyed seeing him in a sit-down video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, guys.